we've had quite a number of requests to discuss herd-bound behavior or being buddy sour. And I thought I'd sort of take the opportunity because my two boys spent about 3 months straight right next to each other, you know, pastured together while we were in the States over the winter. And Boone, the Palomino here, is a little more prone to these sorts of things. And so we've got some of that going on here. So my name's Ben Longwell, a True West Horsemanship based mostly in New Zealand. And I hope to help you with this real common problem with some strategies and ideas of what we can do. So first of all, we have to recognize that this is a natural kind of a thing in that the herd dynamics are going to be that they want to be together and that they feel safe as part of a herd. That's just completely natural for a horse. They want to be able to see other horses, be around other horses, interact with other horses, and have their pecking order on their structure all figured out. That's part of the way they are safe and comfortable. So it's completely natural that they develop these things, and it's completely natural that they worry about it when we come along and disrupt it. What we want to do is establish a norm that's a little more workable with what we're going to want to do. So if I want to be able to ride this horse out by himself or take the other horse out by himself and leave this one here and not have this kind of behavior, I need to establish a norm that sets them up to be a little more okay with that. So one of the first things I've done with these guys is start to pasture them separately. Now I still keep them within eye shot of each other. Sometimes even across the fence you might need to, depending on how you're set up and what you're able to do. We don't want them stressing like this all day long, okay? So we want to try to bite off a smaller chunk if we need to. Horses are all different, but one like this who's pretty nervy and full of energy and sensitive, he can give himself ulcers doing this all day long, and you don't want to do that. So what we're working on is just getting him a little bit more used to the idea of being separate while he's still within eye shot. Now right now he's not within eye shot. I've moved the Ento, my other gelding, and so that's one reason why he's not settling as well as he would be if he was still in eye shot of the Ento. Okay, so this is one thing that we can do to just gradually make the norm a little bit easier for the horse to cope with when we do separate them, or we want to go take one and not the other, or whatever the case might be, is get that little degree of separation going, okay? Again, within eye shot or sometimes even across the fence, but let them start to grow gradually more accustomed to less closeness in their relationship. Okay, now you'll notice that he finally has settled here a little bit with me, okay? And I knew that he would probably do this, is he's looking for, and there's another sign, that's a sign of nervousness and you know, probably a bit of an upset stomach and whatnot, is that runny manure, of course. But he's looking for some help here. He's come to me because he knows I can help provide leadership as well in his world, and he's feeling like maybe I'm a pretty good substitute for the other horse. Now, not all horses are like this, and not all relationships with their owners are like this. We need to be able to provide consistent, meaningful leadership in our horses' lives for them to look to us as a good substitute in a case like this. But this is what part of what I'm looking for too, is if I'm just going to hang out here with him for a minute, I'd like him to be able to make that change in his mind and say, actually, maybe this isn't so bad. I can hang out with you and be safe. So it's a good step in the right direction. There's a few other strategies that I would use and be aware of, especially in the realm of working with them when you're wanting to actually ride one of them and do something with them. You might have to set some things up, and we're going to talk about that here in a minute. So we're ready now to do a little work with this, and we have sort of set up a scenario here, and this can be done a lot of different ways. One thing I wanted to mention, too, is we have just moved to this property, and so both of these guys are a little wary about the new surroundings and just figuring out where they're at, and that would accentuate the herd-bound behavior where they sort of feel like they need each other, particularly this one needing the older, more confident horse. The general premise here is goes back to one of our horsemanship principles: make the right thing easy and the wrong thing difficult. And we could set up the stationary horse anywhere, tie him up somewhere, and just let him be our magnet. And what we're going to do is try to help this horse be more and more okay being further away from this horse. In the meantime, you know, and to sort of set up the contrast between the two, you know, what it's going to be like is when we get down here nearby this other horse, this is where we're going to get busy, okay? And we're going to do some stuff right around close by here. We're going to keep things pretty busy and pretty intense. There's not going to be a lot of rest going on while we're in this vicinity. And the closer he gets to that horse, then the more work it is, okay? So we sort of let him work at it a little bit, and if he's got to be here and wants to just be here and be here and be here, then we're going to we're going to keep this a pretty busy, intense few minutes, and we can do transitions of many kinds, work on changing the bend, and working around. This horse is real frisky and forward usually when we get started anyway, so it's not unusual to have plenty of go with this guy. It's just being able to redirect it and give him some confidence around it. So we're in pretty close proximity to this other horse, and I'm just going to let him get his busy. Now right there, he just sort of made a change, and he just sort of said, let's head up this hill here. And I know that you probably couldn't see anything. But I felt a distinct change in his mind from coming around and staying close to that other horse, and he offered to come up here. And I just went with him. Right about in there, I just sort of offered him the chance to drop out of that lope. So I slowed my life down, the rhythm of my seat, and I just offered him the chance to come up here and catch his breath. Okay? This is what I'm talking about, is his mental willingness to disengage from the horse and engage with me and go somewhere else. Okay, now we're still within eye shot, we're not that far away, but it's the principle that I want to demonstrate and change, help you see the change. And I haven't done a lot of this with this horse. Matter of fact, one session basically last week, since we've moved here and I've started working on getting this separation anxiety dealt with, we worked on this. And already he recognizes there's a spot where there's a work zone, and there's a spot where there's less work to be done. And starting to get that separation set in his mind where it's okay to come with me and go do what we're going to do. So then to build on this, you might take him further, or you might take him out of eye shot. Those sorts of things are going to raise that level of separation and test his ability and willingness to stay with you. So right now I might do a little bit here, and I might find that he starts to want to draw back down there, okay? And I'm not gonna keep him from going back down there, all right? I'm just gonna set it up here to see if he would rather come on back on up the hill. No, he switched bends on me right there. He dropped into the left bend. He wants to come back down here and be closer to his buddy, and we just hit the work zone, okay? So we're going to have to work at it here a little bit. And again, whatever physical proximity you think needs to, easy, hey. whatever you need to work with to show him that there's a workplace and a rest place. Now again, he's pretty willing to leave here, and he sort of says, yep, let's get out of here. And again, I've only done one session with him of doing this, and he's already picking up, hey, hey, Quit running through me. There's a boy. He's already picking up that idea that it can be easier elsewhere. One more thing that I often will practice, and I'll do this even before there's any problems, and that is to step off my horse at different places. Not always right back at the barn where we started, not always back at the other horses where there's a comfort zone and there's their buddies around. I actually want to be able to step off away. And even if that means I got to walk back a ways, or sometimes I'll even pack my saddle back. I'll pull the saddle off too. When we step off, loosen the cinch and pull that saddle, that's all kinds of relief for these guys. And they get to thinking that that could happen just about anywhere, anytime, as long as they're coming with me, as long as they're coming, you know, and being willing and engaged with what I'm doing, then that could happen any place. Okay? So again, whatever you're capable of doing to bring the intensity up, I don't have to push on this guy at all to get forward motion. And he works himself harder than what I probably would. But just these changes of bend, keeping him in that little trot as we go around here and having him work at it. Okay. And they don't get, when they're in physical proximity to their buddies here, they don't get any relief. Okay. There's no relief to be had in this zone. All right. It's when you feel them make that change and they would offer you that change to leave, that you might sort of say, okay, well, that's that, we could do that. There he goes again. He just wants to leave. And so we'll just trot up here and give him lots of nice quiet relief. We're just coming around here, and not, there's no pressure. The intensity's gone way down. The intensity's gone way down. That's a whole lot easier being out here. Okay, so you let him blow and think about that, and you set up that contrast to and it could be, you know, depending on your horse and your level of relationship, your quality of leadership that you've presented to him, this is not going to always make changes this quick. He's made a pretty quick change here just from one little session we did the other day. But again, going out of eye shot will be the next real big thing. But hope you find that helpful and that gives you some tools to work with. Have a good day, and we'll catch you down the road.